Vuyo Zungula from the ATM uthi the reason the public protector cleared Cyril Ramaphosa on Phalaphala, he was cleared due to favor. Ramaphosa needed a favor and the public protector needed a favor. Remember, by then she was still an acting public protector. She came into an office as an acting public protector, so she needed to do something, and she needed to Ramaphosa a favor so she can get an upgrade to the actual office of being a public protector. Yet Ramaphosa needed a favor himself, that he needed to be cleared so he can continue his presidential campaign. But Vuyo Zungula and ATM, basically they are saying, right, there's something off about this. In an article written by Sipho Jerk, under IOL, it says it was published on the 7th of July 2024. It says the African for Transformation Movement ATM believes the Phalaphala report represent what they call it a quid pro quo arrangement. Aye, right there, quid pro arrangement. You know those words, Mo. They sound. All right, exactly how I think about it. You're like, hey, Bongs, that's a rhyme of some sort. Well, don't worry. MK political party have asked some very serious question in parliament, right? They are asking questions, Uguti. People must account, and everybody that gets into this parliament, especially the president, you must declare your interest. How come Phalaphala didn't declare all of that? Those are some of the questions that are being asked. So you can tell that the scandal, the Phalaphala scandal, it's coming left on the left, right, and center. ATM, they are bringing you, they are pushing for that one. While MK Party, they are sitting in parliament and asking the right questions. Uguti, wait. You must declare. Let's forget what the public protector say. That's MK Party. They are like, nah, we hear the public protector. But when do you agree that there was money under your mattress? And Phalaphala agreed live. You cannot deny that. So then the MK Party, they are saying, wait, we don't have a record of you declaring that. That's a violation. Aye. MK Party, they are bringing something to the table now. MK Party, they are changing the game now. They're like, aye, see, nazi nina ngathi mhlawumbe not wozala. Awusichazele, did you declare? It's a question that President Ramaphosa hasn't answered even as of now. And he will have to answer that question. But I know, you know, I'm on a journey to 60,000 subscribers. So you have to answer this question. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
In an article that reads as follows, ATM President Vuyo Zungula told The Star on Sunday that at that time the public protector, Kolega Galega, public protector, was conducting her investigation into the matter, she was in need of President Ramaphosa's favor for a promotion from acting public protector to a permanent position. While the president needed a favor to be cleared, or needed a favor to clear his name. So it was such a coincidence that both people needed favors. But it was a matter of principle at the same time. That if you compromise, this compromise will later on jeopardize you. Nevertheless, No, don't worry. Minage, you know me. I bring it all. Bring all the evidence. Lest you accuse me of. Mister, where are the facts? Well, here are the facts. Zungula said that this is, look, said that as his party sought to get the court to set aside the public protector's report, which cleared Ramaphosa from any wrongdoing in the Palapala farm scandal, he said that a movement that they were confident that the court will ultimately set the report aside. He said, the public protector's report appears to deflect blame away from the president, focusing on other people instead. As the ATM, we maintain that the president is guilty of multiple offenses, including violating Section 41, Section 34, he's guilty of multiple offense, including violating Section 34, Paragraph 1, PRICA, and Section 96. Guys, what am I reading? I'm sorry. Hey, man. He says, the president is guilty of multiple offense, including violating Section 34, bracket 1, not paragraph, bracket 1 of PRICA. And Section 96, bracket 2, bracket A, and Section 96, bracket 2, bracket B of the Constitution, as well as 2.3, bracket F of the Executive Ethics Conduct, or Code of Conduct, if you like. So you can tell that Ramaphosa Segaya Tatazela. He's tatazeling. You know what I'm saying? He's tatazeling because, wow, they are closing on the man. Yeah, like, we didn't join the government of national confusion because we didn't join the government of national confusion because we want to deal with Palapala. So if we join that, we might not have the time, or we might not be given the freedom to deal with Palapala. So let's rather not join this one so that we can deal with the man. They say the reasoning behind the public protector's conclusion is frankly baffling to us at Tetuzum. On the question of whether the party was confident it had a strong case, the ATM leader said he was confident that they have a strong case, arguing that the public protector's interpretation of paid work was problematic. He said, the Constitution clearly states in Section 96, bracket 2, that members of the cabinet may not undertake paid work. I have laid out our argument comprehensively in our court filings, and while the issue is now before the court, it is inappropriate to litigate it in the media as well, which is very matured, lest Palapala get away with this one. But I like this one. It brings another angle as well to say, this one, Section 96, bracket 2, that says members of cabinet may not undertake paid work. Ramaphosa, you see, Ramaphosa did a lot of things. He undertake this, and he also agreed that he got paid in dollars. It's a violation. It's funny that the newspapers are not writing about it, that Ramaphosa violated the Constitution. If it was Zuma, I'm telling you, we would have known about it, the amount of money, the interest rate. But today, the media is silent about Ramaphosa violating the Constitution. Earlier this day, the public protector argued in court papers that neither the provision of the law nor the legal precedent allow her a leeway to challenge the South African Revenue Service refusal to give insight into Ramaphosa's tax wealth. Zungula said that noted that the apex ruling came a month before Kalega made her report public, right? He continued to say that the public protector had an opportunity to challenge the SARS refusal to give her access to Ramaphosa's record on the basis of confidentiality provision in the Tax Administration Act. You see, guys? You see, guys? I'm thinking. Palapala, you see, the fact that the media is quiet about Palapala and scandal, it should teach you that the media, it writes about people, they write about people they hate. It's not a matter of facts or the country. This, it's a lie. It's delusional to say the country will collapse under Zuma. Palapala, this thing, Farmgate, Palapala, what is happening? Why these newspapers are quiet? Obviously, excluding IOL. Why these people are quiet? Why don't you see Ramaphosa being written in a negative way? Why? It should worry you. If you think that media is fair, let's read this. He continues to say that the public protector had an opportunity to challenge the SARS. Okay, we've read that one. I think I wanted to read this one. Newly appointed public protector spokesperson Kulu Pasiwe said the office received ATM's replying affidavit. He, however, said it was not a new application. He says, the public protector South Africa confirms the receipts of the applicants, local applicants replying affidavit. This is not a new application. It is still part of the original litigation. The parties will file their respective heads of argument and later. The matter will be ventilated by hearing on the date still to be set. Right. So, bayamlanda ke uPhalaPhala. But PhalaPhala, you cannot get away with this one. PhalaPhala, you can't. You have been getting away with a matter. We did not have a problem with you. You know, we had a problem with you, but you know what? We'll come for you. We'll come for you. There's a Zulu saying that says, Akukho zinyane lemvubu yes. Ladliwa yingwe, kwaqweba ini, khuluman lapho, delan. You can't steal and tell us about, because right now, today, I came across a paper that is written, Daily Maverick, speaking about state capture, as if Ramaphosa is not involved. It says Zuma state capture. Hey, Ramaphosa is involved in the state capture. Do not allow media to deceive you. They write deceptive articles because they want to confuse you. They write things, deceptive newspapers, just because they want to clear it. Just because they want to clear Ramaphosa, it shows that Ramaphosa is their guy. Ramaphosa has got to deal with them. They wouldn't have always speak good about Ramaphosa, even when it is not necessary. No, they wouldn't have done that. But they are doing it because Ramaphosa is their guy. The question is, why is the media so dull? They are very dulling when it comes to Ramaphosa. Very hostile when it comes to Zuma and FF. No. These ones are going to corrupt the country. No, we need to save the country from these ones. But to Ramaphosa, no. The country is safe, you know. Why are they feeling so comfortable around the man? It's a question that you and I have got to ask. Why is the media, whom we know who runs the media, why is the media feeling very cozy and very comfortable around Ramaphosa? Ramaphosa this, Ramaphosa that. Why are they feeling so comfortable around the men? It's something that you and I need to study. I'm very worried. Tell me if you're not. And also, the fact that Ramaphosa get away with court things, it just doesn't give me peace. And then he comes to you and say, we are following processes. I'm like, my man. The processes that are manipulated. My man. No. We are following the processes. The next thing, the processes that we are following, it leads to people who are clearing you because they need favors from you. Hey.
siyamabheka njalo-ke mfate ezivalo sicashile ngacanti azibasinibo siyanibuka njalo qhubekani kodwa